it's snow solidly packed on the field. The wind is blowing a good 25 to 30 miles an hour, and I can't get any feel for which way the wind is blowing.
Third down, they need seven. He drops back to pass. He's looking down the middle. He pumps it, throws it, and it's caught on a deflection by Jurevicius. He's up the field. Jurevicius slides, and he's got the first down. Well, it got deflected off of Edwards and then right into the chest of Jurevicius. It's going to be about a 35-yard field goal attempt for Phil Dawson kicking into the dog pound. Snap is back. They've got it down. Dawson punches the ball end over end. That kick is up, and it is good. He got it. And believe me, that's big.
That's an
adventure. This kind of day. 35-yard field goal, and he punched it through. It was at the 10. 8-0 the Browns lead. 15 seconds left. The rookie quarterback takes the snap. Back to pass. Lobs it over on the right side. Jackson's got it. Headshot. Thompson hit him. And he didn't get the first down. And the Browns are going to win it.
And the Browns have a shutout.
They throw a pass into the right flat for Fred Jackson. And he got stymied by Sean Thompson at the 10-yard line. And the Browns have won 6 straight at Brown Stadium. They got a 9-5 on the year and are on the doorstep of making the playoffs.
On the ensuing Jaguars possession, brought down by Charles Johnson, so they would have to punt after that. And that's when the monsoon hit. Cheerleaders not taking it, but the fans were loving it. And boy, was it tough to play in these conditions with the rain pouring down. 5-3 and Carolina ahead in this one. And Gabbert is intercepted. Hard to see even the cameras. Just their visibility was shot by the rain. Blaine Gabbert just throwing one up there, intercepted by Sherrod Martin. As you can see, players sloshing around on the field. So Gabbert with a tough start to the game. Cam Newton having difficulties as well, having trouble hanging on to the ball, trying to get rid of it. He's able to dump one off to Greg Olsen for a loss of 4. The rain just affecting both teams. It was miserable, but that's why you give the ball on the ground to Maurice Jones-Drew, making guys miss, dragging players down for a 39-yard gain. So despite the low score and the rain coming down, Jaguars finding a way to move the ball, and they were doing it with Maurice Jones-Drew setting up a 1st and 10 at the 36. So with 6 seconds left, could they make something happen? Gabbert steps up in the pocket, throws downfield, finds a wide open Mike Thomas, fighting his way into the end zone. That is the first passing touchdown of the season for the Jaguars. A 2nd and 1 after that catch, but this would be the last play. Could they tie things up? Another miracle? Not this time for the Jaguars. Cam Newton and the Carolina Panthers get their first win of the season for Cam Newton. That would be his first career win, as the Jaguars were unable to get it done this time. The ball batted down, hits the ground. Panthers come out victorious.
A rainy Monday in the Steel City with dangerous weather in the area. Our kickoff delayed 25 minutes, but 8:55 Eastern, just 10 minutes from now, the Steelers and Dolphins will kick off on Monday Night Football.
It might have been, it picked. A play looked at just as well as this punch. Brandon Fields struggled earlier, got the wet ball away. Allen Rossum go. And it looks like it's on a tee.
Boy,
if you tee the ball up, you couldn't put it any better.
You can go for the pin today, can't you, Mike?
Has always been tough. Jeff Reed for the game's first point. No good. Not even close.
2nd and 8. Fans booed the run. Roethlisberger a throw, and it is caught by Hines Ward.
Red zone alert, Michael.
I was just going to say.
Red zone alert.
First down. 2-minute warning. Miami only has 1 timeout left. Roethlisberger swings it out. It is caught by Willie Reed. His 4th catch of the year is a first down.
This is far from a gimme. This is not a chip shot.
The holder is the rookie punter, Daniel Sepulveda. Snap good, hold good, kick good.
Eureka!
So the game is over, and the final is Steelers 3, Dolphins nothing.
The Lions on the road, taking on the Eagles. And
this was special. Not so sunny in Philadelphia. Snowed more than 6 inches during this game. Players had trouble holding on to the ball. Nobody could hold on to that thing. Calvin Johnson just got scattered, smothered, and covered in snow.
That looks fun. It's a lot of fun.
Reggie Bush actually slipped on snow and ice and re-aggravated a calf injury before the game. Second quarter.
Man, please.
Nick Foles looking for Riley Cooper, picked off by Chris Houston, who returns it up the sideline to the Eagles 20.
There goes the streak.
Yep. First interception of the season. He had 19 touchdown passes without a pick. So the streak is done. Peyton Manning still holds on to the record. Third quarter. Donnie Jones punting to Jeremy Ross. And look at this, Prime.
We only show you this for one of two reasons. A big player, Boo Boo. This was a big play, baby. Touchdown, punt return in the snow.
Captivating.
Can't see the goal line.
Never played in weather.
Ed Hockley said we had to clear off the goal line. Thank you, Ed. Six plays later, fourth and goal at the one. That's what you call. You just sneak it up there, right? That's the obvious decision there. The Eagles' two-point try fails, but they still lead 28-20. Foles, two touchdown passes on the day. Matthew Stafford did not end well.
1982, the Dolphins left the warmth of Miami to tiptoe gingerly onto the Patriots field in Foxborough, Massachusetts. The frozen tundra would soon serve as a setting for the bizarre chain of events that would forever be known as the Snowplow Caper.
It's the first time since I've been in professional football we've ever taken such serious exception to something which happened on the field. That kind of thing should not occur as a result of somebody putting a snowplow run by a convict with a day off from prison out onto the field to give special advantage to the home team.
The advantage came with the wave of an arm. When late in the fourth quarter, Coach Ron Meyer sent a snowplow onto the field, it was driven by a convict on a work release furlough. The inmate dutifully cleared a small area in the vicinity of the Dolphins' 20-yard line that enabled place kicker John Smith to get a toehold for the field goal that broke a scoreless tie. The improbable 3-0 win propelled the Patriots into the playoffs, where they quickly were eliminated by these same Dolphins. But the snowplow caper that got them there remains painfully frozen in memory.
Probably shouldn't even be talking about it right now. I think that thing has been buried and dead.
We call time out to clear the area so our kicker could get down on his knees and chip away at the ice and snow there. All of a sudden, this crazy picture of this snow broom and this tractor that was clearing the sidelines at the time flashes through my mind. It's like the proverbial light bulb going off. Spur of the moment. In fact, I think your films will show that I'm standing there talking with Steve Grogan, and I think Steve may have even mentioned it. And I just, a great idea, I grab my headset and toss him to Steve, and I'm running down the sideline trying to locate the driver, and he's standing there just watching the timeout. So I run down the sideline and throw him on the field. He runs out there, sweeps the thing dry, goes the other sideline, and we kick the thing through and win a tremendously big game.
Welcome to the playoffs. For Soldier Field at this time of the year, this is the French Riviera. No snow, no sleet, no single-digit temperature.
The sun was out. It's probably been the upper 30s. Just a perfect day for a game like that.
Snap to Tom Zach. Rushes on. Tom Zach has time. He rebounds the right side. McKinnon wide open.
Was on fire. I thought there was just something going on in the east side of the stadium.
Either smoke or fog rolls in over Soldier Field.
Whatever, it's eerie. It looked like a football game when they're introducing the players, and this fog was just artificially being pumped in. It was the most amazing thing that I've ever seen.
Dense fog bank sat out over the lake. And it was daytime warming that caused this cool, dense air out over the 32-degree waters of the lake to start moving inland. There's fog, and then there's fog. The fog bowl was fog.